Good evening, everybody. Once again, my name is Todd Able. I'm one of the operations section chiefs. My job on this one, this fire for John's Type 1 team, is to run the field operations, so I have a pretty good understanding of what's going on out there. I'm not going to start all the way at the beginning, but I'll kind of start a couple days yesterday. I'll start 2 days ago and kind of work forward from there. So some of this stuff up here along this north flank here was causing us some problems a couple days ago. I'm happy to say we were able to get in here with some dozer work and some efforts in here, and that's looking very secured. I flew it this morning. Very cold, a little bit of smoke here and there, but there is a solid dozer line in there, so things are looking really good in there. As I come around to this side, this is obviously new. This came out on us yesterday. We got some serious winds that came down off the Cascades, downdraft winds, pushed this fire really hard right through here. We were working on trying to get this door shut here before that happened, and we didn't make it in time. As we were trying to get that door shut, the fuel conditions in there were very rough to kind of work through there. We had to do things very slow and easy through there. And we didn't quite make this gap, and this is what happened with when we got those serious winds yesterday. Last night, we put a bunch of resources in there, obviously, and our main focus was this north side here. And the reason for that is all these values at risk up here. That's a priority for us. Obviously, life safety for the firefighters and the public are our number one priority. Infrastructure, private land, everything that goes along with the beautiful place you guys live. We worked really hard last night to get this in. About 8 o'clock this morning, the dozers made it right to that drainage. And they were able, couldn't go any further because, I don't know if I'm gonna pronounce this right, so bear with me. Deschutes drainage. Thank you. They hit it right to the drainage edge, and I think most of you guys know how steep and fuel loading that's in that drainage because it's a wild scenic view. So they're able to make it there. This morning, the day resources got in there. They immediately went to work. We knew we had to get them in there as early as possible for the heat of the day. And we had hot shot crews come down off this and get hand lined in all along the front of this. We can't obviously get dozers down in there, it's too steep, and we'd hate to ruin what that beautiful place looks like, but we couldn't get them in there anyhow. So we've got crews in there watching that right now. I want to be perfectly transparent with everybody. A hand line here compared to a dozer line, I'd rather have a dozer line, but this is going to look really good. It's held for most of the day. My concern is with any more of those serious winds that go either down canyon or come out of the west there, could impact that. But so far things are looking really good. We also did some retard work in here. I'm sure you've seen all those fixed wing aircraft working today. We did a bunch of retard work in here, so in case it did want to come out of there, we had something to fight it with right here. And we also did a little bit right here for the private structures that are right in this location. So that was why you've seen the air tankers flying a lot today. Coming around this side, this was a little bit of a challenge for us. This got very active right through here and a little bit through there. Today, that's where you're seeing most of that smoke. Like I said, our main efforts were here to keep fire from going this way. We were trying to get in here and try to catch that. It just got way too active and way too early on us this morning. It generated that energy and that heat, and it kind of kept growing. The good thing is this is the old Pole Creek burn, which is a good fire star. Some of the stuff on the edge is still carrying fire pretty good. We were able to, that smoke lifted a little bit today, and we were able to get some retardant in this area to kind of check it up and slow it up so we didn't impact the 16 road hard. That was very successful, and they're still working on that as we speak. The crews had to disengage in there. It was too dangerous for the firefighters in there with the amount of fire. So we disengaged them. Things are looking better, and they're starting to poke in there and look at what we can do. The plan for tonight will be we're going to get some dozers in here and go as direct as possible on that and try to just crawl that thing back down into the old Pole Creek burn or try to just get around it. There are a couple issues. There's some drainages in there that are pretty thick, so tonight we'll push dozers direct as far as we can. We'll do the same thing from this side And then tomorrow we'll get some hot shot crews in there to look at it and see if they're comfortable kind of hand line down through some of those steeper drainages, and that we can get them out safe if something did happen to them. So we will work hard tonight, try to button that up, and then tomorrow hopefully we can maybe shut that door on that part, just so it doesn't cause us any issues on this corridor, which would affect, could possibly affect some of the values at risk out here. I feel pretty comfortable about this stuff just because of the local fuel treatments and prescribed burns they've done and some of the fire scars they have in the area. I think we have a good chance if something did happen on the 16th. I feel like I missed this last time, so I want to cover this with everybody. I want to cover some of this north and west side of what will eventually happen up there. It's tough for me to see the roads, but the 242 and some of the private land that's in this location, we have stuff in place to get around that. When I mean stuff, we have lines, hand lines, dozer lines, all that stuff in here to get around this. And then we're gonna look at prepping the 242 road all the way up to Lava Lake, and then look at the potential if we have to do any firing in this area to make sure it doesn't get across the 242 to all these values at risk right here. So that's kind of a bigger picture in the long term. Right now we're focused on this stuff due to these values at risk right here. Thank you.
Well, good evening. First of all, I just want to thank you. I can tell you that evacuation decisions are not made lightly, and we had a lot of painstaking conversations over the last few days as far as what we can do to make sure that our community is safe, but that we don't want to unfairly impact the community. And so we recognize that and we take it very seriously. But number one, we want you to be safe. We want you, your homes to be secure. And I can tell you that the Sheriff's Office, our primary mission is the safety and security of you and your friends and your family in these communities. Yesterday afternoon, obviously the fire managers came to us and talked to us about what was going on there along the 15 road. And clearly that elevated the risk to communities around the fire. And so we ultimately, in coordination with the incident management teams and local agency administrators, made the decision that it was important to make evacuations notices to make sure that you had a proper notice and that you knew what was going on. I'm going to talk a little bit about how those decisions happen. First of all, you know, we take fire behavior, what's current and what's expected. That's predominantly the biggest driving factor. But also we consider what these communities look like, how much time we think it's going to take to get people out, how much ingress and egress, or how you can get in, how you can get out, what our available resources are to get people out. And you know, all that comes into an equation, and it's essentially a risk-based decision. So we look at what the values at risk are, what our ability to get people out, and what potentially could happen in that fire. And we get that information in concert with the fire managers. And these professionals, I tell you what, I've been absolutely impressed by their performance. And I really hope that you're proud of what's going on out there in that fire. I can tell you that we have continual conversations. I think we've had multiple conversations just today, in fact, about different potentials, different contingencies. And I can tell you that everybody on that team and everybody on our team is working together to ensure your safety. You know, what the future brings in the next day or two, you know, obviously we don't have a crystal ball. We don't know exactly what that means. But I can tell you that as soon as it's reasonably safe, and that there is some certainty that fire, that it would be prudent to get people back in their homes. That's what we want to do. We recognize the impacts that is to you and this community, and we want you to get back in there as soon as possible, but we're not going to sacrifice your safety to do so. And I just want to end with the fact that we're so thankful to be able to serve this community. Currently, the Sheriff's Office is, we're staffing 3 to 4 extra, actually I think 5 right now, extra deputies in the Sisters area to ensure that we are in those communities, that we're assisting with the roads that are closed and escorting people into their homes that have to get in their homes to for critical needs. And we'll continue to do that as long as it's necessary. We're going to be in this for the long haul, just like these gentlemen and ladies. But finally, I just want to say again, thank you for your patience. We appreciate the concern that you have for us and the decisions that we have to make, and recognize how much we care about you. And I tell you what, this is a super fire smart community. You've been through this before, and we appreciate just how well you work with us. So thank you very much.